All right, next section here. Trig functions of angles. Finding the sector angle or arc length. Arc length, okay? Sector angle, here's our circle Pac-Man thing. The angle right here, this is the Greek letter theta. Theta, okay? They use Greek letters all the time. But that's the angle that we're in the middle there. Okay, so we have a radius of 5 and an arc length of 6. What is this going to be? Okay, I just got to get used to here. Okay, we're talking about centimeters even. So here's the formula, I guess it is. Angle theta is going to be arc length over radius. That's it. So 6 cm over 5 cm. Well, okay, cm and cm, they cancel out. You have 6 over 5, and that equals what? 1.22, okay? So theta equals 1.22. Are we talking about 1.22 degrees? No. But because we know that there's no units left, there was never any degrees introduced at all, there's no units, nothing here implies radians. Okay? So theta, in this case, equals 1.22 radians. That's the angular measurement of this angle. Okay, now how do I was gonna say how to get out of that. No, that's perfect. That's perfect. Okay. So I suppose we could find out what the actual angle of this is here. If this is 1.22 and 180 equals 3.14, we have a mystery angle theta equals over, okay, theta 180 degrees to 3.14 radians is mystery angle theta to 1.22, okay? So I guess in order to find this out, we would just cross multiply theta times 3.14 radians equals 180 degrees times 1.22 radians divided by 3.14 divided by 3.14, and whatever this here would be that's radian, those cancel out, you would get some kind of number in degree form. Okay, that's how you find the numerical degree angle, the numerical angle in degree terms for this little Pac-Man's mouth here, okay? And in the next video, we'll show you the next one, okay?